In this video, we will show you how to connect a load cell with the controller and how to find out either load cell is okay or not okay. It will work or it will not work. So please see in last today we learn what is load cell. Load cell is actually a transducer that is used to convert a force into electrical signal. So these are some varieties of the load cell. So it works as a voltage is directly proportional to force, or force is directly proportional to voltage. So how to get this force in terms of electrical signal or voltage? The most common type is strain gauge load cell. So every load cell have some strain gauges which used to detect the voltage. So here we will discuss about what is a load cell and how it convert into a voltage. So load here is converted into the electrical signal, so it become a load transducer. So we have taken one example here for the load cell. It has a four resistance, or you can say a four strain gauges. When pressure or force is applied on it, strain gauge compress or depressed, that a signal of resistance is used in the bridge circuit, and that bridge circuit, when it got unbalanced or balanced, it will give some output and it will measure by amplifying. So what is a strain gauge? Strain gauge is a device, you can say, used to measure the strain of the output. The most common type of strain gauge consists of insulating flexible backing which sub a metallic foil pattern. Here you can see example, or you can say picture with of the strain gauge. It is a resistive load principle. It works on a resistive load principle. So right side you can see a load cell which have a four strain gauges. When force is applied on the gauges compressed, or you can expand, it will cause a resistance change in the strain gauges, and that will be a measure in the form of voltage by a bridge. Let us move to another picture. Here we have an hanged load cell. It has a four strain gauges. So when we applied a force from the top or the side of the load cell, it have some tension and compression in the strain gauges, and it got thicker and shorter, and some got thinner and longer. So if we see the resistance formula for this, so resistance is equal to rho L upon A. Here R is a resistance and rho is a property of material, L is a length of wire, and A is effective cross-sectional area of the wire. So when we applied force on this, it's got tensile or compressed. When it got tensile, its length and resistance will increase. For when it got compressed, its length and resistance would reduce. So the total changes in the common measuring using the Wheatstone bridge means the total resistance change is commonly measured using a Wheatstone bridge. So this is the basic principle of strain gauge. So Wheatstone bridge. What is Wheatstone bridge? A Wheatstone bridge electrical circuit used in a load cell to measure an overall changes in the resistance. So in first figure we can see a test specimen. We have two strain gauges, and the side of that we have a bridge. So R1 R2 is the strain gauges. When we applied a force on it, in second picture you can see the resistance got unbalanced, or resistance got changes. So bridge is unbalanced. So first picture have a balanced bridge and second picture has unbalanced bridge. So in unbalanced bridge we can get voltage changes. What is the difference between four wire and six wire load cell is given below. First we'll take a four wire bridge. Here SG1, 2, 3, 4 are the strain gauges in the bridge circuit, where excitation positive and negative take from the upper and lower end of this bridge, and side of the bridges we can take output. So for 6 wire the similar pattern is there, the 4 strain gauges, but with the parallel of excitation we have taken 2 signal, that is a sensing signal. It will reduce error. It is error correct connection which we use for the reduce the error in the circuit. So these are the difference between 4 wire and 6 wire load cell. So 6 wire load cell is better than 4 wire as it reduce error in the system. We face many problems to connect load cell and the controller, or you can say display or indicator. So if different brand have a different nomenclature, but these are the some common nomenclature for excitation, for signal, and for input output detail. If we see bridge circuit, there is a excitation positive negative and signal positive negative. So some you can say it is same excitation and in is are same, and signal out are same. Excitation positive and excite expectation negative, we can write in, and signal positive and signal negative, we can write in. So these are the connection detail for the load cell and the controller. Now I will discuss type of load cell. A beam load cell used for the vessel and tank weighing and floor scales. S-type load cell, engaging scales or suspended vessel weighing scales. For the shear web load cell, using varying force measurement in press applications mostly. Canister load cell, it is used in heavy duty application for truck scales and railroad scales. Single point load cell, bench scale and check weighing scale application. Tension link load cell, used for the mooring, submersible testing and crane scales. So these are the type of load cell. These are the application of load cell. A simple load cell used for the weighing of general material by putting a platform on. So another example is the tank with have actuator signal. We can convert into through PLC or controller or drives to set the level of the tank. So another example is for we can use it for conveyor feeding system. We can take a printout, we can attach a recorder or touch screen or set value. So for the feeding, conveyor feeding, we can use this. Another example application used for the screw conveyors, where we can use a tank and a screw conveyor and control the material or level of controller, and we can put it into SCADA or PLC or another monitoring system. This is also used in tank application for the filling system, bag filling, bottle filling, cane filling, tank filling. Lot of applications are there for the load. Now we'll find how to find a load cell is okay or not okay by measuring its resistance. So measure resistance between two excitation wire and then measure resistance of output wire, you can say signal wire or output wire, and the result would be nearly same if it is okay. And for not okay, if resistance is not showing, load cell wire got open or broken, load cell should not be bent, means load cell should not be twisted or damaged. These are the two cases where we can nearly find out whether this is okay or not okay. Sometime a load cell got some scratches, some bend and some twist and other. So it also affect on the load cell performance. So always use a new load cell with checking resistance and all these values. Let us take example of some PCB. You can see here is a signal, a 6-wire load cell connection, where the signal positive, negative, sensing negative, sensing positive, excitation negative, excitation positive and shield wire. And the for 4-wire, you can see here excitation positive, excitation negative, in positive, in negative. So these are the some examples of load cell connections. Please subscribe this channel for latest videos and updates, and also press bell button for the latest videos. Thank you.